Now, let's start English 1. Today is Friday and date is year 14, 8, 2020 plus 12. Total English, page 74. Now, I'm missing all of you. I hope our school will reopen and we will meet once again in the class and you will have a nice time and we will study seriously. Now see here, question number 4B. Question number 4B, 1. Now see here, you have to read the instruction first. Answer the following questions in your own words as briefly as possible. 1. What put the narrator on a trial? What put the narrator on a trial? That is a question and you have to read the passage. As I told you earlier, you have to read the passage 2 times, 3 times and read the questions 2 times, 3 times. Certainly you will find the answer. You will be able to locate the answer in the text, in the passage. And what if you come across a difficult words, look up the dictionary. You will find the correct words, correct use of that word. Now see here, what put the narrator on a trial? The answer is here. See, the narrator was sitting on his easy chair, idly turning the pages of a paper-backed book. Someone had left on the bus when he came across the reference that first put him on the trial. That is the answer. Now we are going to question number 2. Now let's see question number 2. What made the narrator's heart to pound and his breath to choke his windpipe? Now see the answer. Thank you. and his breath choked. He has stammered on and accidental. Accidental. Mention of a totally unfamiliar. Obviously, it is very good. Real yet to the car was perfectly natural. Okay. So now I have answered this question. Now see here, the second question is, what made the narrator's heart to pound and his breath to choke in his windpipe? That is the question. Now see, the answer is here, the narrator's heart pounded and his breath choked in his windpipe. He had stumbled on an accidental mention of a totally unfamiliar race, obviously non-terrestrial, yet to the character in the book, it was perfectly natural suggested, they belong to the same species. That is the answer for question number 2. Now see question number 3. Question number 3 is, how does the narrator's knowledge of biology help him to understand the new race of creatures? How does the narrator's knowledge of biology help him to understand the new race of creatures? That is the question. Now let us see answer. Alright, now see answer for question number 3. As I read the question, I will read once again. How does the narrator's knowledge of biology help him to understand the new race of creatures? Okay, now you see the answer. Without battling an eyelash. generators, knowledge of biology. Came in handy. Came in handy at this point. They are simple. They are simple things. Some sort of primitive. Single cord. All things. No more depth than a starfish. All right, now say here. Yeah. Answer now, because answer question I have read, but I will read once again this question here. How does the narrator's knowledge of biology help him to understand the new race of creatures? Answer is, without battling on I/, the narrator's knowledge of biology came in handy. At this point, obviously they were simple beings, unicellular, some sort of primitive, single-cord things, no more developed than a starfish. So that is the answer. I will say it clearly. Now we stop for today, only this much. We shall continue tomorrow. Till then, goodbye.